I'll tuck that away. That's where I need to go. Never know when I might need these. Hello. Going down. Grab this now.
Thank you. Zero won't last much longer. Poor feet.
Decent work keeping the city safe.
I've sent a messenger to the claim to let everyone know.
If there's anything you or your clan need for her arrangements, you need but ask.
There'll be time for all of that later.
Aloy, I'm glad you're back. I'm at a loss about Ursa. To learn she lives, then lose that hope seems cruel.
She wouldn't want us to waste time talking. She'd want us to find Durval. She said he raved about smoke darkening the sun. Tell him what you found in his papers.
A letter. It mentioned a shipment of Blaze being sent to a warehouse here. Only, it wasn't addressed to Durval. The name was Aeland Forgeman. Does that mean anything to you?
Sounds familiar. Yes, a landlord. The Oseram have been buying up buildings across the city, including one under that name. Let me think. It's by the edge of the mesa, near the temple. Used to be a shop, but it could serve as a warehouse. If Durval used the name as an alias to buy it, he might even be there now.
I'll round up my men.
I'll meet you there.
Erend, wait. Remember that no one hates Durval more than your own tribe. The clans would give up much to obtain him.
Take him alive? So you can haggle over him? You can't be serious!
Our security depends on keeping the peace. If the opportunity presents itself, take him alive. Consider that a command. Aloy, a moment, please. When we spoke, Aaron didn't wish to dwell on the details of Ursa's death. Understandable, of course. But now that they've been left to my imagination, those details are all I can think about. You were there. Did she suffer?
She wasn't worried about her pain. She was worried about her brother. And she was worried about you.
Thank you, Aloy. I suppose I needed to know I was as much on her mind as she is on mine. Find Durval and bring him before me. He will answer for his crimes.
Spare a moment to speak.
Don't bother the betters and keep your hands to yourself, stranger.
His father may have been a butcher, but Sun King Avad is a reasonable man.
Able-bodied adventurers, preferably with no friends or family.
That
I'm
must
not
be
choosing.
The spire. It's huge.
This is the place. You home, Durval? I got a surprise for you.
Or he has a surprise for us.
Is it a bomb? Doesn't look too big.
It's big enough to kill us.
All right. I'll shut up.
Blaze. It must be leaking from something upstairs.
That's a lot of blaze.
If that bomb downstairs goes off, it'll be just what Durval promised. Smoke will darken the sun. As the city goes up in flames, there's gotta be a way to stop it. If we can get rid of it somehow, the blast will be much smaller. If I try to take it apart, a booby trap will set it off. It looks like a wooden bracket. Not very strong. Help me push this out.
Okay. Brute force. I'm good at that. What'll it do?
Save the city, I hope. But when the blaze falls, run for it. Because the booby trap on the bomb downstairs is gonna get set off.
Will we survive?
Probably not. Now push.
We did it! Durval's best shot, and Meridian's still standing.
This isn't over. Durval said he'd make a Vob watch.
No way. To do that, he'd have to get into the palace. Now that's too heavily guarded.
Get back there, just to be sure. I'm gonna look around. Maybe Durval's men left something behind when they planted that bomb.
I got it. Don't worry. He tries for the palace. He's finished.